Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 5.2. We are going to discuss about the flow meters. So the topic are the flow measuring devices like venturi meter, orifice meter, flow nozzle, rotameter, elbow meter, pitot tube, and we will be discussing about the momentum equation. In the earlier lecture, fluid dynamics, we discussed derived the Euler's equation and the Bernoulli's equation for the fluid flow. And the flow measuring devices, they are working on the principle of Bernoulli's equation. So, all the flow measuring devices, we are going to apply the Bernoulli's equation between two points and we will calculate the, we will determine the amount of water flowing or liquid flowing through the device. And the learning outcome to the student at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the working of flow meters, calculate the flow rate of liquid using the flow meters, and discuss the momentum equation. And the first flow meter is venturi meter, and this is the cross section of the venturi meter, and this is the practical venturi meter available commercially. So there are two tapping points, and this is the pipe through which the liquid is flowing. We have two opening here. So, through the opening we connect the pressure gauge or the manometer to calculate the pressure. And in the venturi meter we have three sections. First section, so this is the first section, this is called as converging cone. The total inclined angle is 20 degree or 21 degree. The length of the converging section is 2.7 times of diameter capital D minus small d, where capital D is the diameter of the inlet of the section, and D is the diameter of the throat. So this is called as the smaller cross sectional area is called as throat, small d. Normally the angle is 20 degree or 21 degree. And we have a throat section, length equal to the diameter of the throat. So, D, length of the throat equal to diameter of the throat, and diameter of the throat equal to half of the diameter of the pipeline. So, small d is equal to 0.5 times of capital D. And the third portion is the diverging cone, divergent cone. The total angle is 5 degrees to 15 degrees, preferably 6 degrees. So, this is the construction of the venturi meter. So, the venturi meter, we have two opening. One is at the converging section, entry of the converging section, and another one is the throat. So, we connect with the pressure gauge, or normally we connect these two opening to the U-tube manometer, so where we can measure the difference in the pressure head. So, from the difference in the pressure head, we can calculate the pressure. So, where we take W is the specific weight of the fluid, A is the cross sectional area, P is the pressure, V is the velocity, and Z is the datum level. So, subscript 1 is the inlet section and the 2 is the throat section. So, we apply the Bernoulli's equation between inlet and the throat sections of the venturi meter. So, this is the Bernoulli's equation. Bernoulli's equation, it gives the total energy at any point in the fluid flow is constant. The total energy, it has got the three components, pressure head, velocity head, and the datum head. So, P1 by W, specific weight, is the pressure head, V1 square by 2G is the velocity head or kinetic energy head, Z is the datum head or the potential energy head, due to the potential energy. Now, P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 equal to P2 by W plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2. Now, we assume that the venturi meter is horizontal. So, when it is horizontal, Z1 equal to Z2, then the equation is it will become P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G equal to P2 by W plus V2 square by 2G. Rearranging the terms, P1 by W minus P2 equal to V2 square by 2G minus V1 square by 2G. And this value, the above expression, P1 by W minus P2 by W is called as difference in the pressure head, which is known as Venturi head. So, difference in the pressure head is the Venturi head and denoted by H. So, H equal to V2 square by 2G minus V1 square by 2G. And from the continuity equation, the theoretical discharge. So, from the continuity equation, we have Q equal to A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. So, A1 is the area of the converging section and A2 is the area of the throat section. A1 is the velocity at the entry converging section. V2 is the velocity at the throat section. So, from the equation, we can calculate V1 equal to Q theoretical by A1 and V2 equal to Q theoretical by A2. So, we substitute V1, V2 in the previous equation. So, we will get H equal to Q theoretical square divided by 2G into 1 by A1 square minus 1 by A2 square. So, rearranging in the terms, Q theoretical equal to A1 A2 divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. And there are some losses of energy as the fluid is flowing through the Venturi meter due to the non-uniformity of the fluid flow. So, on account of this, the actual discharge is less than the theoretical discharge. So, the actual discharge is given by now. So, Q equal to CD. So, CD is the coefficient of discharge. So, coefficient of discharge equal to actual discharge divided by the theoretical discharge. So, the actual discharge equal to CD into theoretical discharge. So, CD into A1 A2 divided by A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. And the value of CD is the coefficient of discharge. And the value of coefficient of discharge for the Venturi meter, it is around 0.98. Generally, 0.98, around 0.98. So, you have to, the geometrical parameter A1 and A2, you have to calculate. And using nanometer, we have to calculate the H, the Venturi head or the pressure head. So, once you know the Venturi head or the pressure head H value, so using this, you can calculate the flow through the Venturi meter, the quantity of flow through the Venturi meter in meter cube per second. So, you have to calculate. So, but nowadays practically we have flow meter which will directly indicate the quantity of the flow in meter cube per kilogram, meter cube per second. But here Venturi meter will give the accurate value for flow measuring of any liquid. And remember this equation. This equation is very important for solving the problem. So, Q equal to actual discharge equal to CD into A1 A2 divided by A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2G H. So, H is in meter, A1 A2 in meter square. And this is the Venturi meter. So, we have tapping point at the throat section. We have the tapping point at the converging section. And here also we have the tapping. You can find out the fluctuation in the flow, difference in the pressure in the sections. Then if the U-tube manometer is used to measure the difference in the head between 1 and 2. Suppose you use the U-tube manometer and X is the pressure head. And we have to calculate H value equal to X into Sm by S minus 1. Where Sm is greater than S and H equal to X into 1 minus Sm by S for Sm is less than S. So, Sm is the specific gravity of the manometric fluid and S is the specific gravity of the flowing fluid. Normally, when we determine the flow through the Venturi meter, water is the fluid flowing through the Venturi meter, then we will be using mercury as the manometric fluid. And the Venturi meter is also used to measure the flow rate of air or gas. So, in that case, we can use some other liquid as the manometric fluid. So, Sm is the specific gravity of the manometric fluid and S is the specific gravity of the flowing fluid. It may be used for liquid as well as gas. And when the Venturi meter is inclined, then we have to consider the Z value also. So, the H value now, it includes the pressure head and the datum head. So,
So P1 by rho g plus Z1 minus P2 by rho g plus Z2 equal to x into Sm by S minus 1. For Sm is greater than S. And H equal to P1 by rho g plus Z2 minus P2 by rho g plus Z2. This equal to x into 1 minus Sm by S. For Sm, specific gravity of the manometric fluid is less than the specific gravity of the fluid flowing through the ventrometer. So, Sm is the specific gravity of the manometric fluid and S is the specific gravity of flowing fluid. And the next device is orifice meter. So, orifice meter, the meter diameter of the orifice is approximately 0.5 times the diameter of the pipe. So, you look at here, we have an orifice plate. We have a flange arrangement. So, we have orifice plate and on the downstream side we have a pressure gauge and the upstream side we have a pressure gauge. So, this is upstream side, this is the downstream side. So, here the area is A1 and here the area of the orifice plate is AO and A2 is the area of the Vena contracta. So, this is called as Vena contracta and you may find some vorticities, circulatory flow in the area. The two pressure taps are provided, one at the upstream side of the orifice plate at a distance of 0.9 to 1.1 times of the pipe diameter. So, the upstream side is approximately 0.9 to 1.1 times of the pipe diameter. Another tap is on the downstream side of the side nearer to the orifice where the velocity will be maximum and the considerably pressure will be minimum. So, nearer to the orifice. So, nearer to the orifice we fix another gauge. Now, instead of pressure gauge, sometimes we may connect these two tappings to the U-tube manometer. So, like our venturimeter, here again we can connect with the, normally in the laboratory practice, we are connecting with the U-tube manometer, then we measure the head directly. And we look at here, this is the orifice plate where the fluid is flowing and there is a pressure fluctuation here on the downstream side. And once again, P1 is the pressure at the section 1, V1 is velocity at the section 1, A1 is the area of the pipe at section 1, P2, V2, A2 are the value at the section 2. And once again, we apply the Bernoulli's equation between section 1 and 2. So, the same value P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 equal to P2 by W plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2. And we assume that orifice plate is, orifice meter is horizontal, Z1 equal to Z2. Then the equation is simplified as P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G equal to P2 by W plus V2 square by 2G. Rearranging the terms, P1 by W minus P2 by W equal to V2 square by 2G minus V1 square by 2G. And again in the above expression, P1 by W minus P2 by W is called as difference in the pressure gauge denoted by H. So, H equal to V2 square by 2G minus V1 square by 2G. Or V2 equal to V1 square in square root of 2GH plus V1 square. So, the velocity on the downstream side. Now, the section 2 is Vena contracta and A2 is the area of the Vena contracta. So, the area of the orifice AO and the area of the Vena contracta A2 are related by coefficient of contraction. So, the coefficient of contraction equal to A2 by AO. So, A2 equal to CC into AO. So, A2 is the Vena contracta, the area of the Vena contracta which we cannot measure. Geometrically, we can measure only AO. That is why we are converting in terms of AO. AO is the area of the orifice. A1 is the area of the pipe, cross-section area of the pipe. Now, from the continuity equation, A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. So, V1 equal to A2 by A1 into V2, which is equal to CC into AO by A1 into V2. Now, the V2 equation. So, in the previous V2 equation, we have the V2 equation here. So, in this V2 equation, we are going to substitute for V1 square. So, substitute for V1 square from this expression. So, V2 equal to square root of 2GH into CC by CCAO A1 into V2 whole square. So, there are V2 both side, left side and right side. So, rearranging and simplifying, we will get V2 equal to square root of 2GH divided by square root of 1 minus AO by A1 whole square into CC square. CC is the coefficient of contraction. And the discharge Q equal to A2V2 equal to A2 AO CC. So, substituting Q equal to, rearranging Q equal to, substituting for V2, so R AO, so CC AO into square root of 2GH divided by R divided by square root of 1 minus AO by A1 whole square into CC square. Now, the coefficient of contraction in terms of coefficient of discharge of the orifice material is given by, so CC equal to CD into square root of 1 minus AO square by A1 square into whole square into CC square divided by 1 minus AO by A1 whole square. So, from here, from this equation, we will calculate the, we substitute the CD and the Q value is modified. So, discharge equation is modified as CD into AO A1 divided by square root of A1 square minus AO square into square root of 2GH. So, equation is very much similar to the Venturi meter. Instead of A2, we have AO.
The range of coefficient of discharge for the orifice meter CD value is 0.6 to 0.64. And the for flow measuring and the laboratory level, we are using the Venturi meter and the orifice meter. They are very popular flow measuring devices. And there are other devices for flow measurement. We will discuss one by one. First, the flow nozzle. So, flow nozzle is a modification of the orifice plate. So, instead of orifice plate, we have a nozzle fitted to the flange. So, the nozzle, so here the nozzle is guiding the flow. So, here again we have the pressure tapping at the upstream side and the downstream side. And the fluid is flowing through the flow nozzle. And we measure the pressure or the head. Using the head, we are going to calculate the flow rate. And this is the image of the flow through the flow nozzle. So, the equation to determine the flow rate is the same as the Venturi meter. So, the discharge calculation using the Venturi meter Q equal to CD into A1 A2 into square root of 2GH divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square. We have to use to calculate the flow rate, where A1 is the area of the pipeline and A2 is the area of the cross sectional area of the nozzle. And CD is the coefficient of discharge. It is very much similar to the Venturi meter, 0.98, around 0.98. The next flow measuring device is the rotameter. So, in the rotameter, we have a, so look at the real rotameter fitted in the pipeline for flow measurement. So, you have a metal casing and a glass tube. So, on the surface of the glass tube, you may find the graduation scale for measuring the flow rate. And you have a metal float. So, the metal float is lifted because of the fluid flow. The metal float is lifted and the position of the metal plate that shows the flow rate through the pipeline. So, the rotameter, so the pipeline, the surface of the scale is marked on the glass tube. The scale will show the value of the flow through the pipeline, through the rotameter in meter cube per second. So, using the rotameter, we can directly read the value of flow rate of the liquid. Normally, the rotameter is fitted in the corporation for the measuring the flow rate of water. So, water meter, we call it as water meter. So, that it will directly indicate the flow rate of water. So, this is the water meter is working on the principle of the rotameter. And next one is elbow meter. So, in the elbow meter, we have a elbow joint and it is connected to the two flanges, and on these two sides of the elbow, we have the pressure tappings 1 and 2, and these two pressure tappings are connected to the manometer and we measure the head. So, using the H value, we can calculate the flow rate. So, as in the Venturi meter calculation, we can calculate the flow rate, that is the elbow meter. This is one possible methodology of measuring the flow rate. And next one is pitot tube. So, pitot tube is very popular flow measuring device and it is used to measure the velocity. So, the velocity determined V equal to CV into square root of 2G into delta H. Actually, this is measuring the velocity head or velocity. And here, look at the pitot tube. So here we have a pipeline at the center of the pipe where the fluid is flowing. And the fluid with the same velocity is flowing through the pipeline and entering. It is acting on the right side of the U-tube manometer. On the left side, it is connected to the pipeline. So this is acting as a piezometer, and this is giving the velocity head. So the pressure difference that gives the velocity head or velocity, the head, delta H is the velocity head. So using the velocity head, you can calculate the velocity of the fluid flowing through the pipeline. So pitot tube is used for measuring the velocity of the fluid flowing through the pipeline. So just by measuring the pressure at the center of the pipeline and pressure at the pipe surface, so we can calculate the velocity of the fluid. So here Cv is the coefficient of velocity of the pitot tube. It is above 0.95. Delta H is the dynamic pressure head. So by measuring the pressure head using U-tube manometer, we can calculate the velocity. So pitot tube is also an important device instrument for measuring the velocity of the fluid. And next we discuss the momentum equation. Momentum equation is based on the momentum principle or law of conservation of momentum, which states that the net force acting on the fluid mass is equal to the change of momentum of the fluid, momentum of flow per unit time in that direction. The net force is equal to change of momentum per unit time, that is rate of change of momentum. So from Newton's second law of motion, F equal to m into a. So force equal to mass into acceleration, where a is the acceleration acting on the direction of the force, F. The acceleration is the rate of change of velocity with respect to time. So F equal to ma. So m equal to a is change of velocity with respect to time, dv by dt, or F equal to dmv by dt. So F dt equal to dmv. So F into dt equal to d into differentiation of m into velocity. So this equation is known as impulse momentum equation. So we are going to integrate this equation to calculate the forces in the two directions. So the impulse momentum equation is used to determine the resultant force exerted by the flowing fluid on the pipe bend. So when you have a pipe bend, so what is the force exerted on the pipe surface by the flowing fluid? So we have a pipe bend. So we have section 1 and section 2. So section 1, the force acting is P1 into A. So A is the cross-sectional area, P1 is the pressure of the fluid. So the pressure force acting on the surface equal to P1 into A. And similarly here, on the second section, the pressure force acting on the surface equal to P2 into A. So the P1A is center, it is vertical, perpendicular to the plane of 1. And here we resolve into two directions, right? Horizontal direction and the vertical direction. So the horizontal direction, the velocity is V2 cos theta, and the vertical direction velocity is V2 sin theta. So here the force in terms of forces, P2 A2 cos theta, horizontal force, and the vertical force is P2 A2 sin theta. So this is the Fx, force in the x direction, Fy, force in the y direction. So let us take V1 equal velocity at the section 1, P1 is the pressure at the section 1, A1 is the cross-sectional area at the section 1, V2 is the velocity at the section 2, P2 is the pressure at the section 2, A2 is the cross-sectional area at the section 2, Fx is the force exerted by the bend on the fluid in the x direction, Fy is the force exerted by the bend on the fluid in the y direction. So resolving the force, the momentum principle in the x direction gives net force acting in the fluid in the x direction equal to rate of change of momentum in the x direction. So net force equal to P1A minus P2 A2 cos theta minus Fx equal to rate of change of momentum equal to PQ into V2 cos theta minus V1. So V1 is the velocity at the section 1, V2 cos theta is the horizontal velocity in the section 2. So Fx equal to PQ into V1 minus V2 cos theta plus P1 A1 minus P2 A2 cos theta. Similarly, the momentum equation in the y direction is given by the net force acting on the fluid in the y direction, that is equal to rate of change of momentum in the y direction. So 0 minus P2 A2 sin theta minus Fy equal to PQ into V2 sin theta minus 0. So in the section 1, the force is acting only in the perpendicular direction. So the the components of force is zero, and components of force in the y direction is zero, and here the velocity is also zero. So FO equal to PQ into minus of V2 sin theta minus P2 into cos theta. And the resultant force on the acting on the bend FR equal to square root of FX square plus FY square. And the angle by which the resultant force is acting with the horizontal direction is given by tan theta equal to FY by FX. And the moment of momentum equation. The moment of momentum of fluid per second is given section 1 equal to rho Q into V1 into R1. And the moment of momentum of fluid per second in section 2 equal to rho Q V2 into R2. So, according to the moment of momentum principle. So, that is equal to resultant torque equal to rate of change of momentum. So, torque equal to rho Q into V2 R2 minus VR V1 R1. This principle is applied to analyze the flow problem in turbine and the pump to find the torque exerted by the water or the sprinkler, on the sprinkler. So, the force, the torque equation is very important in future for solving, for deriving the work output of the turbine and to calculate the force by the sprinkler. And next topic is a free liquid jet. So, we have a jet of water coming out of small nozzle with a velocity capital U. And it is rising to a particular height and falling. So, this is the trajectory path of the jet. So, this you can find in the garden. So, when a jet of water is leaving the nozzle and it is flowing to a maximum height and then falling down. And here again we are going to calculate various parameters for the free liquid jet. So, here U is the velocity and U cos theta is the horizontal velocity, U sin theta is the vertical component of the velocity, and the maximum height attained by the jet S equal to, so the maximum height S equal to U square sin square theta divided by 2G, and the time of the flight, the time required for the flight equal to time taken by the fluid particle to reach A to B, to reach A to B equal to T equal to 2U sin theta by G, and the time to reach the highest position T star equal to T by 2 equal to U sin theta by G. So, the A is this point. So, B is the other end. So, A to B is the distance traveled, horizontal distance traveled by the jet. And the horizontal range of the jet X star equal to U square by G into sin 2 theta. And the value of theta for maximum range equal to theta equal to 45. And x star equal to u square by g. So, the maximum range x star equal to u square by g, where u is the velocity of the jet emerging from the nozzle and g is the acceleration due to gravity. And we stop here. So, this is the end of the discussion on the flow measuring devices and the momentum equation. And these are all the books I published in the mechanical engineering subject, design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, and you may find the book fluid mechanics and machinery, which will be useful for further reading in the subject. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subject mentioned here, and the solution for the gate question paper is also available in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel and use the videos for your better learning and pass in the gate examination. Thank you for watching the video. Please post your comments on the comments box. And you subscribe the channel, you will get the intimation regarding the updation of the videos in the channel. And you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification or doubt. So, we'll meet again in another video on fluid mechanics and machines.